face of journalism has changed in significant and dramatic ways. As I'm sure you've noticed, newsrooms have become smaller. Digital media has become the first port of call for keeping up with breaking stories. And the rise of dis and misinformation poses potentially the greatest threats to media credibility and our democracy. Well, my co-anchor here on The Full View, Tsepiso Makwetla, will take us through some of the issues that will be discussed tonight at 7 o'clock at the Credibility of Journalism panel discussion at the Goethe Institute in Joburg. Tsepiso, good evening. So who's on your panel tonight?
Good evening, Stephen. So we're going to have five panelists. Wits lecturer Glenda Daniels is going to be joining us. Chris Vick, whom many South Africans would know, is a spin doctor and a media strategist, including Holger Stock, who's head of investigations at Die Zeit Online from Germany, who also a former journalist himself. Will also be speaking to Virashni Pillay, journalist and editor, head of digital at Power FM. She's got a story to tell, of course, about this particular issue. And Nikiwe Pikicha, who will be speaking on behalf of SANEF. She's a former broadcaster and radio journalist who's currently sitting on SANEF's inquiry into media ethics. So we're coming to you from the Goethe Institute's library. And Stephen, as you can imagine, the interaction, the relationship between media theory and theory in media on various issues, which then for some people is where we find ourselves, why there are certain fault lines that seem to appear in our transitional democracy, because the whole issue of the narrative by certain media institutions, organizations, columnists, on commentators on particular issues have raised the issue of whether or not we need to check ourselves as the journalist sector, not only in terms of truth-telling, fact-checking, but also how we go about collating some of the information that we put out there in the spaces. Stephen, you spoke about the fact that the face of journalism has changed. Has that created greater space and reason for criticism? And has that criticism been constructive enough for the journalism fraternity to really do some navel-gazing and improve? Some people have said perhaps journalists need to be more transparent, nail their colors to the mast in terms of the ideologies that they put across so that they're not hiding behind this objective of plurality of views and opinions, but in fact are open about what views that they actually support. So the Media Monitoring Africa has suggested that perhaps there needs to be a credibility index. They are working on something like that. How would that work? How would we then measure what credibility is? And of course, Stephen, we'll have to talk about the source of why we find ourselves where we are in this time of our political history, where we are questioning the future of journalism and credibility.
Tsepiso Makwetla, thank you very much indeed. All right, she'll be live with you tonight between 7 and 8 o'clock, sharing that debate.